Hey everybody, it's Invicta. It's time to hopefully continue our Binding of Isaac back to Eden streak here. Well, that last run was certainly a thing, and we're sitting at 42, hoping for a good start. I'm just gonna, it's a new day, I'm ready to move on. Hopefully you get all the butterflies out of the way, and we've got ourselves an interesting start here. You see today is gonna be 0 Juliet, Whiskey 4, Kilo 3, Victor 9. We've got little Steven and my best friend, which can act as a sort of a pseudo-bomb. We've got great movement speed and great damage and actually great range as well. And a double card. So, okay. We've gotten a lot for this. I'm not quite sure what we did to deserve such a good stat. We also have 3 HP, which is beautiful. But yeah, I don't remember picking up Eden's Blessing or anything. This is just a really strong start. And for those of you who may be new to Isaac, or you're not exactly sure why, this is still a question that I see every now and then. A lot of people want to say, like, why are Eden Streaks considered, like, good? Like, what's the big deal? The reason why Eden Streaks are kind of used as the paramount of, like, skill, if you want to say that there is skill in the game, which of course there is. It's the reason why, apparently we have Curse of the Blind, I didn't even realize that. It's because we basically have everything randomized at the start, so, oh god, so much better. Everything including, like, stats, items, etc., etc. So this is a really good start for a, you know, for an Eden streak here. We do have our secret room here as well. So obviously we're going to be leaving with the crystal ball. Do we have enough rooms? We should have enough rooms to actually utilize my best friend here to get into the secret room. But anyway, yeah, everything with an Eden start is completely randomized, including all stats, HP, items, etc. And the reason why it's considered sort of the gold standard of what is considered skill in the game is due to the fact that there are certain situations that you can find yourself in really nasty starts. Luckily we haven't had a bad start in a little while now, and I probably just really jinxed myself. But whenever you get a good start like this with Eden, you're always expecting sort of like the other side to sort of come out of nowhere. By the other side, I mean like the downsides of, like, well, we've got a great start now, what's going to be the next run? You know, you really just don't know. I am going to instead of using the my best friend on the on opening up the secret room, I'm going to use it for the boss, because it does act as a little bit of a pseudo taunt, as well as a bomb as well. And so, I mean, I'm not going to worry about too much about taking down Gemini. Not that Gemini is a very scary boss anyway, but the fact that we already got Big Gemini out of the way and we've got little Steven here helping us with little Gemini, this is going to be an already easily won fight. Of course, with the Crystal Ball, I'm absolutely going to be taking that. One of the best support items in the game, especially for spacebar items. It gives you a chance to get a Tarot card and or a Soul Heart every time you use it, and it's a guaranteed full map, full compass reveal outside of the super secret room, which makes it very, very good. So I'll take an HP upgrade here, which is what we got. We're not going to have any Soul Hearts, which is a little bit sad face. We do have enough money to actually make the shop worthwhile, though, if we want to go buy one. And I hope that there is actually one in there. We also have this Perthro room, which we're going to be using, which we can use for a reroll. Obviously, I'm not going to use it on Curse the Blind, because that would be a little bit silly. So I'm going to hold on to that. We're going to use one of our keys here and go into the shop and hopefully pick up a Soul Heart. Please be one in here. There's not one in here. A little bit sad face about that, although this keeper should give us at least 5 cents. Yeah, so when we get another 2 cents from our donation machine. So we didn't get a Soul Heart, not that big of a deal. We need to be a little bit cautious as far as protecting our red hearts. And I could spend a little bit of time of taking down those poop piles, because they do have a small chance of getting a Soul Heart, but I want to keep things moving along here. Burning Basement, Curse of Darkness, I'm fine with this. And we're just basically playing for... By the way, the trinket we got is Maggie's Faith, and that's going to produce us an Eternal Heart on every floor. Now, it's our job to protect said Eternal Heart, but if we lose it, that's okay, because we get another chance of saving on the next floor. We basically have... Our job right now is just to stay alive until we either get a full charge or get a Soul Heart drop. The full charge will give us a roll on the Crystal Ball, which has a good chance of giving us the Soul Heart. And of course, a Soul Heart is just that's what we're looking for. That's what we're gunning for right now. I'm not going to rush this room because this can be a little bit not dangerous. I mean, it is dangerous in a way because you have this champion fly down here. But our fire rate is actually not as bad as I would have been led to believe when I'm looking at the stats page, which is something else that I kind of wish that they would ever improve upon. Like, I want the stats to kind of reflect exactly what I see. I realize that within the nature of the game, it's you're not really going to have accurate stats, but I feel like it should be improved a little bit. Obviously, I'm not going to go into the arcade right now because I'm more interested in just finding a soul heart. Or a tinted rock would be nice as well. We don't have any bombs, unfortunately. We have a key, though. So if we can just get to the shop and get a soul heart, that would be good. We did get a bomb here. Secret room's probably to the left of there. We get Midas Touch. Midas Touch, not bad, not great. It's going to turn anything that we touch to gold. And it will also deal scaling contact damage based on how much money we currently have in our possession at this present time right now. What's awesome is that if you destroy an enemy that's been turned into gold, it will actually produce you more money, which is very good, which inherently makes it more powerful, which means that, you know, Midas Touch, it's not the worst item in the game. It's not one of my favorite items because you do have to make contact with enemies in order for you to gain any sort of active, you know, active advantage out of it. But it's still very, very good, especially if you have HP to waste or if you got really good orbitals, etc. It's a very, very good way to nullify the mom fight. So we were able to get our soul heart, which is what I'm super duper happy for. We get the Steam sale along with a playing card. Definitely want to take the Steam sale here. It's early enough here in floor 2 that's going to give us a lot of value. Do not want to lose the soul heart. And I also kind of want to check out this playing card here as well. Unfortunately, we're going to be 1 cent short. That's okay. And what did our... Let's see. Super Secret Room might be over here. Let's go ahead and fight our boss right now. I don't have a charge on the crystal ball anymore. That's fine. We've already used it to get what we needed, which was the soul heart. Monstro shouldn't really be a big deal. We've got our Perthrow rune ready to go for the reroll and deal with the devil. And we are set up for a very... Hopefully a very smooth ride here. As opposed to that last episode, which started as a smooth ride, and then I got a little bit too ahead of myself. And, yeah, I need to temper my expectations. I have to remember that Isaac is a very difficult game. And it will kill you very easily if you're not careful. Alright, so we got more HP. I'm not going to reroll that. And we get Little Brimstone. I'm probably going to take Little Brimstone and then reroll the HP here from Monstro. The only reason why I did that was because so we can possibly get another stats up. That would have been nice. Unfortunately, it didn't happen. And yeah, there is our... Let's go into our secret room if we can. We actually cannot access that. I'm not willing to lose this Eternal Heart. So I guess we're just going to go down the next floor. A little bit of a disappointment of a floor here. I really was hoping we would get something other than HP, but we ended up getting the Steam Sale, which is fine. Minus Touch is going to help us out a little bit, and Little Brimstone, of course, is going to kind of supplement our damage, which is very good. No curse on here, which is great. The regular secret room should be right north of this room, because it almost always is. All right, so BFF is certainly a possibility that I would like to explore. We have an easy access. We just need 2 bombs to gain access to this bedroom. Suicide King. Let's get that out of my inventory right the heck now. I do not trust myself with Suicide King, as I've already stated in a previous episode that we've done last week. I have killed myself with Suicide King accidentally before, and I was not happy. So, I know that the... Oh, there's a super secret room, too. Okay, so we need 3 bombs, and we can access everything, including the bedroom there. Because I know that the super... I know that the regular secret room is to the left of that bedroom. It's to the right of this room. There's a bomb. Obviously, I'm not willing to sacrifice our only soul heart for that bomb. Ooh, there's a dime there. So, with the presence of that dime, that kind of makes my decision for me. We're going to look for the shop instead of using our key to get into the item room first. Hangman is actually very interesting because we can use the Hangman card to get this bomb. And we can bomb our way into the bedroom here. And let's take it slow here. The thing about missing though is that I honestly wouldn't mind taking it if we weren't in a streak. I would probably consider it a little bit more if we had a little bit more of a benefit right now, if this were like later on in the run, but it's still very early. And missing no also rerolls your run immediately. It doesn't wait like like for the floor. It will also reroll your run to a new run basically every single floor that you go to. So I'm going to buy the soul heart. I'm definitely going to buy this bomb because we definitely want to get access into the super secret or into the bedroom. I don't know why I want to keep calling it a super secret room. There's also a play that we could do, and I think this might be a little bit of a better play, is using the bomb inside of this mob trap room. And hopefully... using the bomb inside this mob trap room and hopefully getting something out of here, which we did get a lot. I realize that I'm the one who caused that, but I'm still not any less, like, horrified at the fact that that just happened. Luckily, that wasn't our only bomb, otherwise I would have been a little bit more annoyed than I already am about what just transpired there. But yeah, we're not going to be taking Missing No. I'm not going to apologize for it. I don't like Missing No. And it is a dirty bedroom. So dirty bedroom means that there is not going to be a crawl space down there. And we can... If there was an arcade on this floor, I definitely would consider using the bed for a full heal. After a blood donation bank, but there isn't, so I'm not going to worry about it. And right now I'm just trying to finish out this charge on the... crystal ball. Unicorn stump's not bad. It's no crystal ball, though. Crystal ball is top tier. When you talk about amazing space for items and you talk about a ton of value, this is what you want right here. Oh, yeah. I should go check the super secret room. I realize I'm doing a lot of backtracking here, which does not help me with the whole, I want to make better, faster Isaac runs. I'm not trying to rush these runs, but I'm also a little displeased with how long some of these runs have been taking because I feel like I should be able to do better. It's more of a personal challenge to me than anything else. I feel like there's no real reason why we can't fly through an Isaac run, especially even a decent Isaac run, in like 30 minutes or so. Obviously, circumstances sort of prevent me from doing that on every run, but I think that my overall average clear time on for Eden runs especially is probably well below average than the skilled players out there. That's okay. All right, so I'm not going to use this charge on the crystal ball, because I'm just going to save it for the next floor. Do not want to get hit by the champion here. Take a little brimstone, and we got ourselves another Perthro rune, which is fantastic. Not going to take safety cap, because I don't care. And it's going to be hollow. Hollow, this is not going to be a good fight for you, my friend. A little brimstone will make short work of the hollow every time. A little brimmy, I appreciate you showing up again. Not expecting a deal with the devil, but it would be nice. Not gonna deal with the devil. I'm gonna take Crack Jacks only because of the trinket. So it gives us Black Feather. I guess I'll take it because we honestly don't need any more HP from Maggie's Faith. We've already gotten 2 HP ups from our trinket, and that's very, very good. So use Crystal Ball here. It's gonna give us another Soul Heart and also show us the entire floor. There's a vault on this floor as well. Let's go see who this mini boss is. And it's gonna be Ultra Pride, which I did not really want to see. So, do we take the left hand here? I don't think so. We can bomb our way into the shop. I don't see any reason not to. Save us a little bit of keys in the key department. Alright, and again, the steam sale is going to be very good. Deep pockets, I guess I'll take it. It's not a great item, but it's not terrible. Get the key as well. We could buy that full charge for an additional soul heart, and I think that there's no real reason not to do that. Or maybe a better tarot card, actually. I don't mind using a tower card on the boss. Tower cards I've kind of come around with a little bit, and there's our first damage of the day. But you saw how much damage that did to Dingle because we have Midas Touch and we got our money back. So we'll come back on the way after we get this charge here. I'm glad I didn't pick up that full charge. Alright, I will take Iron Bar only because it does give us the concussive effect along with a slight damage up. I'm going to get 2 charges here. We have the full charge inside the shop, and then this is going to produce us another full charge here in a second after we are done clearing this room. Especially taking damage from the Cubone there, I'm glad that I did not pick up that full charge. So we get 1 Soul Heart. I'm going to go back to the shop and get a 2nd Soul Heart. I do realize that I do a lot of backtracking in these runs, which is also kind of playing in part of why my runs take a little bit longer than some other people's out there, but some of these I think are warranted. Other ones I'd probably get a little bit too conservative, but honestly, when you've got a 42 win streak on the line, you don't really feel like taking too many risks. Like, the only time I will ever consider fighting Hush at this point in our streak would be if I have an absurdly high amount of damage. I'm going to use the tower card here. Hopefully we don't get hit too much. We actually didn't get hit at all, so that was a really good tower card, actually. There we go. Take down Chubb. No problem at all. It's a very weird spot for that. And we did not get a deal with the devil, which is honestly shocking to me. I'm not going to check out the vault. I'm just going to go down to the next floor. If I have to carry this Perthor rune to boss rush, I will. But I don't know why we did not get a deal with the devil on that floor. The other floor I can definitely understand, but that floor should have been a guaranteed deal with the devil. Blind Rage, I don't really care about that. I'm starting to question whether or not I should have actually taken the left hand now. Because it looks like the Guppy Dream is just flat out not going to happen. Not that we had a real Guppy Dream anyway, because well, we haven't found anything yet. I mean, we've gotten one deal with the devil, and it was Little Brimstone, which admittedly is a very good item. But I wanted something a little bit juicier. Alright, so there's nothing going on this side. Keeping up the trend of me finding every dead end impossible. Alright, and yeah, we would have gone the absolute wrong way. To be expected from navigationally challenged Isaac players Invicta. I kind of want to check out this mob trap room, although I don't really want to mess with the big room. It's not the worst big room here. I'm honestly shocked that Little Brimstone missed that shot. Let's see what's inside of this boss room over here. I like seeing Pride here because on top of giving a chance for us to get 9 lives, we can also possibly get a, Shoop Doop would be okay. Yeah, I want to take the Moon card. Alright, so we have our Wombo combo here. We can get out of the boss trap, or the boss rush room. And here, I don't think it's really worth doing. I'm just going to go to the shop really fast to see what's in there. And we definitely, of course, are going to go to our item room. Might be too silly here. Full charge. Slightly suboptimal. I'm going to do it anyway. Just because I don't feel like going back. We get 2 of clubs. Fine with that. I say suboptimal because we wasted a full charge there, pretty much. That's okay. I freaking hate Little Haunts. Whoever coded the AI in for the like the Little Haunts should be commended. They should work for NASA because, man, sometimes the counters that those things can make based off of your movements are incredible. So we have the shop here, and 2020 is going to be excellent for us. It's going to give us a nice little damage boost. In the shop, we've got Boom, which will give us 5 bombs. We don't really need it, though. I'm going to pass on Boom just because we honestly, truly do not need any bombs. And I'd rather have the contact damage for Midas Touch as well. I'll use a bomb here to get 5 cents, hopefully. We did, and let's just hurry on down here. There's a Judgment. Not going to play the Judgment. But 2020 will double our shots without giving us a damage down, unlike some other multi-shot upgrades that you can get in the game. And it's widely considered one of the better support items, and I agree with that. It's been a while since we've had 2020 as well, it feels like. Isaac's got a... He's got a weird hipster thing going right now. I feel like I need to be careful what I say, otherwise it might trigger him. Whoa, that was weird. Monster 2 was like sliding backwards while charging up. Alright, so we get Torn Photo, which is great. And we get Krampus, which is ungreat. I don't mean ungrateful either. I mean, it's not really the greatest thing to see here. The question is, do we use our Perthor rune to reroll what Krampus gives us? I think we re-roll the Head of Krampus. We definitely do not re-roll Lump of Coal. Krampus, why do you have to be down there? Alright, so we're not going to re-roll Lump of Coal. And honestly, I'm a little bit relieved that we don't have to choose between that. Because I think that our re-roll is better suited for the boss rush. Okay, so now that we have... We're going to make the boss rush. We just need to make a beeline to it. I just need to get a full charge on the... on the crystal ball, so I know that we're going the right way. And we can use the moon card to teleport out of there. We also have a reroll ready to go in case there's something in there that we don't like. I'm hoping, honestly, that we just get a deal with the devil and I can just use it there. But as you see, our fire rate's just amazing because of Torn Photo, and we had Binky as well. I'm not going to stop for anything right now. I just want to find where the boss is. And we found our first dead end of the floor. Hooray. I am anything if not predictable, that's for sure. My mind was like, stop, you idiot. My finger was like, no, we gotta go. So I guess that's what we're doing. Alright, we were not going the right way. In fact, we're going the literal opposite way that is considered the, quote, right way. Nothing I could do there. I got trapped between two of them. I'm taking a little bit of dumb damage now. I'm a little flustered because we do need to hurry. I mean, we still have like a minute and a half left by the time we get to Mom, probably, but it doesn't mean that... oh, wow, we got a second Steam Sale. By the way, Steam Sales do... I don't know why I laid a bomb there. Steam Sales do stack. So we will now have free items in the shop from now on, which is basically just this floor. I'm gonna be honest, I'm impressed that we didn't take damage there. So we're gonna have about a minute to fight Mom and kill her when we get there. And then we can go sneak into the... deal with the devil real fast and then go steal an item from the boss rush. I should actually let the mom's hood hit me because it will freeze whenever it makes contact with Midas Touch. There we go. I don't know where that bomb came from. Alright, so we've got our deal with the devil, and we get Brimstone, Maw the Void, and a whole lot of other good stuff. So I'm not going to use our reroll here. I'm definitely going to take Brimstone. Inside of our boss rush room, we've got Spider Bite, Anti-Grav, and the Book of Mysteries. You know what? I think that this calls for a reroll. I like you, Spider Bite, but you're not what we need. We got the D8, which is a great item. Anarchist Cookbook, Sister Maggie, and Sticky Bombs. Don't share your bounties at all in one place. I guess we take Sister Maggie, if only to get her out of the Deal with the Devil item pool. Alright, so we've got Brimstone. Brimstone, by far, my favorite item in the entire franchise. I've already said it before. I'll say it again. I love, love, love Brimstone. If you don't like Brimstone, I don't know what's wrong with you. I will admit that Brimstone is overpowered enough to the point where it kind of makes runs seem a little samey, but I'm okay with that as long as we win, man. Or woman. Bean, I don't really care about. We're still going to hold on to the crystal ball because I kind of need the HP assurance, especially after we just lost, you know, one full HP to a champion that we really should not have even touched. But we have the wombo combo of Brimstone and having Maw the Void as well, which is going to give us a lot of piercing damage. And yes, I will take Growth Hormones because that's going to give us a lot of damage and movement speed. We don't have to worry about money anymore because we have double Steam Sales, and honestly, I'm willing to take whatever they give us. If they give us HP, that's fine. Hero Font. Probably should have held on to that in case we actually did get Blank Card. Two of Hearts. I mean, I guess. Good enough. So I'm into our item room yet. Get this Tinted Rock that I saw earlier. I mean, the Soul Heart, we get a lot of stuff. You would almost think that we had Mom's Key. That was a lot of things. I do want to go into the Boss Trap Room. I'll take a Free Nun's Habit. I mean, I might as well take the ladder. And we'll do a little bit of donating here. Look at that. Our donation box is actually almost up to 600 again, which is astounding considering that it was at one time below 200 during this streak, I believe. There we go. Just hit 600. And yeah, take it all, donation machine. I'm fine with this. I am A-okay with this. Yeah, our damage is quite good. Right, let's go check out what's inside of the curse room here. That time my finger was like, okay, I'll stop. All right, we profited 1.5 soul hearts, which is fine. Nun's Habit, of course, is going to give us a little bit even more forgiveness with the... with a combination of the crystal ball. Let's go check out what's in our item room here. And honestly, our tier rate is just astounding that we're charging Brimstone so fast. And we get Tech 10, which is going to give us... yeah, we're going to have some interesting tier effects here. Tech 10 Brimstone is honestly probably the most overpowered combination in the entire game, simply because nothing can escape it. I don't care about money anymore. I just want to see what's inside of the boss trap room. But yeah, Tech 10 Brimstone makes this all kinds of done. There is no way that we lose this. Hello, Abel. How's it going? I apologize, by the way, if it's a little bit too dark on the screen. There's not much I can do about that. The gamma's already raised to, like, the highest levels, so... As you see, our damage actually isn't all that great. It's still very good, don't get me wrong, but... We don't have too many damage upgrades here. And by that is by no means a complaint at all, by the way. I just want to make sure that we're crystal clear on that. And I know that some people are going to like, oh, Sinvictus Tech is Tech X, not Tech 10, okay? It's actually Tech 10, because we don't say Tech II and Tech I for the other tech items. We say Tech 1, Tech 2, and Tech 0.5. I'm just saying. I'm going for all... I'm all for uniformity here. Scarred Womb, sure. Guppy's head is very interesting. That would speed things up as far as, like, clear times go, but I still think that the crystal ball gives us a better survivability chance here anyway. But again, survivability is not really on my mind right now. We're just... I'm looking for more damage, to be quite honest. There we go. We toss the... We're chunking the deuces over to Larry Jr. there. I'm not going to use a key for that. Soul Heart. So we are at full HP. I mean, I could go pick up Guppy's head. I don't think we need it, though, is the thing. We don't really need anything other than just, like, more damage. We can never have too much damage in Isaac. It's gonna be Super Greed. That was an amazing dodge there that I didn't need to make. By the way, just as a tip for Super Greed, all you have to do is just stand still. And his shots will always split around you. They will never hit you. Unless it gets too close, of course. Then, obviously, like, you're going to be sort of taunting the devil, as it were. I need to go back and get that key, but... Oh, yeah, there's this... I was like, oh, why is this door closed off? I'm going to go back to this key real quick. All right, inside is two pills, which I don't care about. Nuns have it, by the way, in case you don't know that item... will give you one charge on your spacebar item every time you take damage. And there's a very easy way to break the game with Nun's Habit. So we got attack flies here. I would like to get these other bombs just because. I don't know why I did that. I just remember we had the ladder. Feel free to laugh at Sinvicta in the comments on this one. It's all right. I can take it. I know a lot of friends that like that get super bent out of shape over you know somewhat negative comments on the internet. I didn't want to use the Joker card there, by the way, because I'm just going to save it for the cathedral. But anyway, like, I have, you know, I've got friends who kind of make a big deal over, you know, someone talking trash to them in the comments or, you know, just they go a little too personal with the attacks, that sort of thing. And obviously, I'm not condoning that by any means. But I got some messages from people, like, they were surprised when I was talking about, this was on the latest Roundtable podcast. They're surprised when I said like bring it on internet, you know. It's not like I'm challenging people to do. Oh my goodness. That's the first time I've seen Magic Mush come out of mushrooms in a very long time. But people are like, you know what you're talking, you're saying that you don't get bent out of shape from negativity on the internet, and I'm like, no, I don't actually. I don't care. I mean, there comes a time that you have to kind of stop, not, I don't want to say stop caring about criticism, but you also can't really, like, kill yourself out of stressing out over people that, like, you'll never, ever, ever have to worry about interacting with, ever. I mean, you know, have I shadow banned people? Yes, absolutely. I think that if you don't do that, there's, you know, you're probably just asking for trouble, unless if you truly don't read the comments. But one of my things is I actually do enjoy reading the comments on YouTube, because I learn a lot. Again, I don't know why I did that, because I have the ladder. Again, feel free to mess with me. I don't care. I do enjoy reading the comments on YouTube, because I do tend to learn quite a bit about not only about the game that I'm playing, but also it's fun for me to interact. I like it. I like people. I like talking to people. You know, I don't like to mess with negativity or anything like that. And you know, and that I wish that everyone could feel like that. I've talked about it before as well. I do feel very fortunate that I don't have to worry about any, you know, mental health issues or depression. I certainly understand the struggles to some degree, that someone in my position can. But what I'm trying to say with this weird tangent is just that, like, it doesn't bother me that much. Like, if I do stupid things and I tell people, yeah, just feel free to make fun of me on the comments, just go for it. It doesn't bother me. I enjoy being my own harshest critic. I think you have to in this industry that I laughably call, you know, that I'm a part of, even though it's the only full-time job I have. You know, it doesn't pay the bills yet, but it certainly helps out. What is this? Justice card. Fantastic. So yeah, so when I say things that, to end this rant, this weird tangent, if I say stuff like, feel free to make fun of me in the comments, just go for it. I don't, you know, I'm inviting you to do so. It's not going to hurt my feelings, I promise. I promise I will not lose sleep over people on the internet. That's not what I do here. I just like having fun. Sure. Okay, well, it wasn't really worth it. I'm going to use the Joker card here. Guppy's Tail, I mean, why not? We're not going to get really any use out of it, but... C'est la vie. Taking the soul heart here. And this run is all kinds of done. Yes, I had an opportunity to fight Hush. I don't think that our damage really warrants that. I'm not going to worry about going after Hush. There's no need to. There's really no point, in my opinion. I'm still amazed that we got Magic Mush out of a mushroom. It's been a very, very long time since I've seen that, as I said earlier, like 10 minutes ago. Well, like more like 5 minutes ago. Wow. Mega Fatty, anytime you want to move their tubs, just let me know. Thanks. Okay, well, whatever. Alge's Rune is going to be very nice that we can use our Midas Touch with. Again, our contact damage is going to be pretty abnormally high. Because we have 81 cents, and that was further helped out by the quarter, the random quarter that we got in that greed room. I'm trying to get close enough to where the Maw of the Void will charge with Brimstone. It's not happening. But this kind of shows you, like, our damage isn't that great. For the great items that we have, it's not, like, amazing. It's not doing gangbusters for us, let's put it that way. But yeah, we're just gonna finish off this this run, and that'll be it. Curse the Lost, of course. Because nothing's easy. Or we can just, you know, go fight Mega Satan real quick, and I think that we'll absolutely do that. I'll go ahead and take Fruitcake because we have Brimstone. And I'll take the body, just so we don't have to worry about dying. So, in the end, like I said, if you want to make fun of me, go for it. But don't think that you'll be immune just because I invite, like, you, like, say, oh yeah, feel free to make fun of me. Don't think that you'll be immune to getting Shadow Banned. Like, there is a little bit of limit that's like, okay, that's pushing it a little too far, because I don't want other people to feel bad about something that other people say. But I do feel very lucky that, like, you know, I've always been able to brush off stuff like that. When you bartended for as long as I have, you gotta remember that I've heard some things that people on the internet probably just won't even hold a candle to, and I'm gonna be honest about that. I've heard some crazy stuff in my time. And that's not a badge of honor either, but I'm just trying to give you all a little bit of a perspective. What hit us? I don't know exactly what hit us there. I guess it was creep on the ground, maybe? Not sure. You know, an item that I haven't seen in a while on our runs is Sad Bombs. You know, Maw of the Void, there we go. Maw of the Void's taking up, like, a really long time to charge for some odd reason. But Brimstone's charging super fast, so I'm not quite sure why. I do have to remember that we also have Fruitcake, so I need to be slightly cautious. Although with Brimstone, we don't really have to worry about Ipecac shots or anything. I'm gonna, I didn't mean to use the Two of Hearts there. I'm gonna pop the Alge's Rune. Come on, Stanley, put out your hands. Or just die, too, that's fine. Waiting for Maw of the Void to just kick in, whenever it feels like it. There we go. It's the most uneventful Mega Stanley kill ever. But yeah, I'm gonna wrap up there. Great run. I'm glad that we got another win down. 43 wins in the bank. hopefully taking it all the way up to triple digits. We'll have to wait and find out. Thank you for the support, everyone. Really do appreciate it. Of course, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.